being selfish thinking that you're the only one with problems, right? It's not that big of a deal. Just get over it. These are some phrases that are commonly used that contribute to the stigma of mental illness. Hello, my name is Jane Ruiz, and I'm here to talk about therapy and why you should try it. I think that it's important for us to seek help for our mental health, especially now that we've been in this post-pandemic, we don't know what Delta's gonna bring pandemic, and all the uncertainties that came with and are yet to come because of COVID-19. Last year, the Jed Foundation conducted a survey of college students' mental health, and a high proportion showed that a lot of college students were dealing with anxiety at 82%, social isolation and loneliness at 68%, depression at 63%, trouble concentrating in class at 62%, difficulty coping with stress in a healthy way at 60%, and difficulty handling emotions at 51%. As someone who has a mental illness and who has a therapist whom I've talked to, though it was not easy for her because I was very stubborn and did not like talking about my mental health and my anxiety. But through my therapy, I know the benefits of it, and I've seen a great change in my mental health and well-being. That's why my goal for today is to convince my audience as to why it would be beneficial for students to consider therapy. First, I will talk about some reasons as to why people choose not to go to therapy. Then I'll discuss what Santa Monica students have as a resource for therapy and what therapy offers. And lastly, I'll discuss the benefits of therapy. Some reasons as to why people choose not to go to therapy would be they'd rather talk to their friends and family, which is great. It's good to have a strong support system. However, it's also important to have someone who's an unbiased licensed source who knows more in detail about mental health and mental illness, that they are able to give you the resources and tools you need in order to improve your mental health, such as psychologists or psychiatrists. Therapy is for people who have serious issues. Clarity Counseling has said that any issue that keeps you from enjoying life is serious, and therapy is for anyone and everyone who wants to see an improvement in themselves. Another point is people don't want others to know that they're seeing a therapist, which is fine. The great thing about therapy is confidential. No one that you don't want to know needs to know that you're going to go to therapy. And my last point is that it costs too much. And depending on your medical insurance or your health insurance, they'll most likely be able to pay some part, but not fully. So it's understandable as to why that would be considered a reason as to why. However, Santa Monica College students have a reliable resource when it comes to therapy. Santa Monica students have the Centers for Wellness and Well-Being. The Centers for Wellness and Well-Being provides a range of psychological services to help enhance the overall personal well-being of SOC students. Some of the resources they have is a confidential short-term counseling and referrals after the short-term counseling to refer you out to other specialists. And a good thing that for the short-term counseling, you can see it as a trial run to see whether or not that actually did work out for you for the better. What therapy offers? Therapy is a way to help people with a broad variety of mental illnesses and emotional difficulties. Psychotherapy, or talk therapy, can help eliminate or control troubling symptoms as a person can function better and increase well-being and healing. The benefits of therapy can be seen as higher levels of social, academic, and emotional adjustments, being able to adjust better into your environment. Improvements in self-esteem and confidence. Better critical thinking skills, and improvements in stress management and communication skills. Another source is that you can gain a better understanding of your emotions. Identify roadblocks and obstacles in order to obtain optimal mental health. And working on unhealthy habits. These points were provided from American Journal Undergraduate Research Department of Psychology, and these points were provided from Medical News Today. To bring this to a close, I think it is important to note that when it comes to mental health, it is not something that we can just get over. It is important to know that when it comes to mental health, it revolves around you as a person seeking out some type of help. The same way that if, when we're sick, we go to a doctor for them to see our symptoms and give us the resources and tools that we need to feel better, we should be able to do the same for our own mental health. So I think it's time for us to treat mental health the same way we do physical health. Because when we are better, we're also better for those around us. Thank you.